Hello, my name is Christian Pederson, and I am a graduate student here at the University of Washington in Kai-Mei Fu's lab. I'm also proud to be a member of the Clean Energy Institute here at the University of Washington, and today I'll be showing you around our lab. Follow me. Welcome to our lab loft. This is where graduate students in physics and electrical engineering get together to design new experiments. In particular, in our lab, we are interested in designing something called a quantum computer. Now, today's computers use billions of tiny circuits, so small that thousands of them can fit across the width of a single human hair. Unfortunately, there are still problems that these classical computers cannot solve. One of these problems is that they are unable to predict the behavior of new types of materials. And this limits our ability to design solar panels, create efficient batteries, and other types of clean energy technologies. Our quantum computers use single atoms trapped inside diamond to work. Now, we can't see these atoms by our naked eye, which is why we use custom microscopes to see them. Let me show you an example. This is an example of one of our custom home-built microscopes. It looks a little bit different than you might expect, but it works on the same principles as any microscope. Our light source is a green laser that comes out of this fiber cage and bounces off of these mirrors. These mirrors direct it all the way through an objective onto our sample below. Then, light from our sample comes back through the objective, travels back through these mirrors, and heads onto what we call the collection path. On the collection path, we have several different detectors that can measure different properties of the light. Here is a closer look at our sample below. Below this objective, you can see our sample being illuminated by that extremely strong green laser light. The atoms in our sample glow red when exposed to green laser light, and that red light is what is captured by our microscope. The red light that comes off of our samples is collected by this objective here, bounces off of these mirrors, travels through this optical element, and onto our collection path. Normally, we look at the light from a single atom, which is far too faint for us to see by eye, but in this sample, enough red light is emitted that we can actually see it on this index card here. That light would then be sent to one of two detectors. One detector is called an SPCM and is able to detect single photons of light emitted by our atoms. The other detector is called the spectrometer and measures the exact color distribution of our light source. Here I am holding a diffraction grating, which is a component inside our spectrometer that is currently separating all of the room lights into its color components. Our lab consists of many microscopes, just like the ones that I showed you before. Each of these microscopes is designed to solve a particular challenge involved with designing and building quantum computers. We really hope that you feel inspired to become a scientist and join the global scientific community so you can help us address these challenges.